fire right now.
And it's fitting that we have the shotgun to start things off. 0-0 into the pistol round of the first half. And Astralis on the CT side, Optic on the T side. And already you can see Optic, very slow start in fact, just ultra passive. It's really just Stanislav running around making noise, but in the meantime, his teammates were waiting for him to show himself over on B, and now they head up straight to long towards that A site.
Yeah, they want to make sure they don't run into any weird stacks or any grenades early on. Stanislav did get shut down. Is that a wallbang coming out on the other side, or did somebody take a jump and shoot? I'm not even sure. A slave. Oh, he gets shut down. Are they going to check the corner? Gary, he's a bit too soon. They didn't check it, but he still fired the shot, and then he gets punished immediately. That's a misstep right there. 3 versus 5 here in the pistol. Dupree trying to charge in from behind. He's going to have to be the hero here. He can't hit the shot, otherwise Stan would have been down. Dupree has to get a reload in the middle of it, but he's going to get shot down. Nafly, now that leaves Device. 10 health in a 1-on-4 is just not happening. Terek will take him down, and Optic, they win the pistol round first here on Overpass.
A perfect pistol round as well. That was a thing of beauty. Showing yourself at B and then just picking up every kill. Kierby jumps the gun as well, and then Mixwell is there to take advantage of it.
That is the deciding moment right then and there, because yeah. If they check it, he's just dead anyway, you know? But when the first guy doesn't check it, it's unlikely the second and third will. And if he buys time and waits for his teammate to get into the bank, It probably, at least it secures them an even trade, you know, that's the minimum they get out of that one.
That's what you're looking for, really, if you're Kirby in that scenario. At least you whittle it down to a 4-on-4, and then you kind of go from there, right? But it just didn't pan out for him whatsoever. And Astralis having to adjust their positioning here on the B site. Dupree, Zipnix, both here. Glaive and Connector as well. So he's not too far off, but again, Astralis going for the force buy in this round, not saving for nades, not prioritizing the fourth round, instead hoping to just try and blindside Optic in this second round. But Optic are playing this very well. They're just grouped up, stacked up, not letting... Well, that works.
It definitely does. They even get that wallbang in on Terek, actually. Incredibly, he's down to 55 health, so scary start. Probably everyone's going to be holding their breath on the Optic side here. They can't afford to run into another Deagle, and there's another one in play. There's even that scout on Device. This could get a little bit scary here. 50 seconds left. They have the grenades, and the fans are behind them, as you can clearly hear in the background. Terek now taking charge of the situation. He's going to be running up. Oh, he looks the wrong way. That's incredibly unfortunate timing. He's going to end up going down now. Glaive with the follow-up. He's got the double. Can't get the third one in, but the flashes are out, and Dupree's shown up with a double kill of his own. Astralis, they steal it back immediately. Oh, no. Optic, I mean, that just did not work out.
That's a bit tough. They went for this play on Cobblestone Astralis. It didn't pan out. They got run over. In this round, though, hats off to Glaive. Dupree with the flick. But you got to give it to Glaive for holding the line on that site. Two kills from him, both of them key as well. Taking down Terek. That's the start. And there's the hype as well. So a 1-1 situation, and now it's Optic who are forcing. They're the ones going for the pistol Kevlar. Mixwell had just enough to get a Galil, so there is a rifle in play for him. But Astralis, they're going to be very hard-pressed here, Optic, to catch Astralis off guard.
Yes, indeed. See if they can trade it back immediately. I mean, if they can, it'll certainly put Astralis in a weird position. Almost Kierby getting caught. He puts out the grenade. He's going to get shot down. Rush finding the headshot in the corner. Another grenade will rain in, and that's Device taking the kill. But he's going to be going down. They stole the Galil and gets the refrag there. Glaive now taking out Rush, and it's a 3-on-3. Glaive staying alive for an abnormally long time in the backline. Finally, Mixwell comes in and takes him down before he's gone. Dupree just 12 health in a 1-on-2 and the bomb down. What a play coming out of Optic already. Stan gets the headshot in, and the Americans are going to steal it right back.
Dupree going so far as to slam the table. But somehow it happens. We're into a brawl here, out and out. Optic are the ones to turn it back their way. And now it's Astralis going for the force buy. They refuse to give up on this. What a shot, though, from Stan. Excellent work. But now it's actually kind of equitable between both of these teams. Decent nade count on Astralis. Two rifles in play. They have the AKs on Optic's side.
What a difference it made that they could buy that one Galil. That really did a lot of damage there. 2-1, the fourth round. And a fairly aggressive hold of the connector between Kierby and Glaive, and Device is nearby and birthday party ready in case anyone tries to sneak that way. Man, this is... You can tell now, both these teams are here to win.
You can't back up in this sort of scenario. You have to go heads in, and that is the setup down here. Kirby and Glaive stacked up in connector. There is a bit of aggression here from Astralis. They've set a trap, and they're hoping for Optic to walk right into it. This is a key part of the map because it allows for the quick rotation of the T side from A to B when they set up their offense. And so Kirby and Glaive just trying to set a trap here to really just catch Optic in that part of the map. But it doesn't even matter. Optic are sticking to the extremities. They're over at A long right now. Four players, and soon to be five. Naphlight hanging around in mid, just making some noise.
And question is, if he walks forward, is he going to get caught by Kirby? He's got an angle where if he stands up, he can just easily get a headshot on someone who's up there. You can see that's what he just tried to do, peek for that one. We're down to 40 seconds here. They're really rapidly running out of time. They do have smokes and everything else to get onto the bomb site, but once they get there, they're going to be sandwiched in between Kirby, and there he comes. Perfect timing, almost catches Naf, and he's going to take a little bit of damage from the grenade, but he's nowhere near enough now. The rest of the push is coming in to the A bomb site. They need to land these kills quickly. Rush going to be in charge of the first one. Sip just putting out a couple of flashbangs here to buy some time, push them back, trying to lay that bomb plant. The bomb is only now making its way onto the site, but they're getting the kills on the Optic team, and it's a 2-on-4.
Oh boy. Is this actually happening? Kirby and Glaive. Now the two players were at connector earlier. One of them is dead. Mixwell hits the headshot. Clean work from him, and now it's Glaive 1v4. And he's actually just looking to get in here, see if he can't take a fight with someone quick, and it's not going to happen. Tarik hits the headshot, and that is three kills for Mixwell in a key round.
You just have to wonder what happens in a world where the first engagement from Kirby against Naphfly is a success, where he gets the kill straight away. I think that probably puts that must ground the round to hold so much. Ooh. That it's going to be hard to really do anything.
Sick setup. Okay.
Someone is ready. Starlight as well.
Awesome.
Fifth round is on. We've got a lot of USPs, single P2000, and Astralis behind early on.
Now the pressure is really going to start mounting, but this is an excellent start here for Optic Gaming. 3-1 lead for them on the T side of Overpass. And Astralis on a hard eco, not spending a dime. It is going to be the stack here from Astralis, though, and they are looking to barrel down short into sewers. If Naphfly can get tempted in, Zipnik's going for his jump. They have no idea that this is coming. Optic, but Rush with the double spray is a UMP. Naphfly is there as well to hold the line, and Tarik will find a kill of his own. Clean work coming in here from Optic Gaming. Not dropping a man. For the first time that they go to the B site, that definitely is going to be a bit of a feel-good moment for them, that it worked so well.
Mixwell, just saw him on camera there. He's 8-1-2. I would say he is the star of the team, and if he's going to show up for the final map here in full force, that could be just what they need. Now, Astralis are back in the mix with M4s. They don't have any Molotovs. They don't have any defuse kits either, which is always worth pointing out. You never know what happens when you get to the end of the round and that bomb is down. Astralis have to stop that from even happening.
And that's why we have the aggro push mid from Kirby. He's looking to just take the fight to him, straight up. He's gonna get caught, however, the counter flash comes in and Rush is able to trade the kill. So we're back into a 4-on-4, and they've used a lot of utility in this round. Astralis already down to a single smoke on Glaive, two flashes, and Rush still hunting for a shot right now, not gonna get it. Well, he does get it in a way, to the face.
The trading continues right now, back and forth, and that will heavily favor Optic. They're going to be fine with that. Dupree is pushed all the way out of B. If he catches Stanislaw with the bomb here, that could be very interesting, but he's going to hold it on for just a little bit here. He doesn't want to continue too much. Stan is actually making a lot of noise, so Dupree should have a really big advantage going into this fight. Stan going to come and check it. Dupree almost goes down. He's on 5 health. That's huge, and now the rest of the team is going to be coming in. Easy kill on Dupree. 50 seconds left. Sip is on the bomb site, and Device is going to be rotating in from Connector.
Yeah, they even have time exactly. This is a great position from Device because it pretty much guarantees that Optic aren't rotating back over towards the A site. So Zipnix can stay put and wait for his teammate to work. Device slowly working his way up short. There's no smoke to block it. No, there is. Just barely. A safe smoke there to stop him from actually managing to get in there. That the bomb deny there would have been key. Instead, it's Naphfly now who has the advantage of positioning, and it's on Astralis now to try and actually create some space. Zipnix pushes forward, and Device looking for the push as well, but Zip caught out of the open, and Naf hits the shot.
Device takes out one, but where's Mixwell? He's hiding right on the other side. Look at this. Such a sneaky ninja. Now he's going to creep around with the AK, shoot him in the back, and that will be another round here. Coming in, Optic resetting Astralis one more time. And if you look at it, I mean, it's not just that they're losing a round. That 2v2, the amount of hesitation on Astralis, the lack of initiative is choking them out right here.
Well played.
I mean, that's all there is to it. Even it's fine that Sipnix is in the back waiting for Device to come in there, but he's got to be a little bit more proactive. He's got to see if he can take a shot somewhere, maybe find out where they're going. Mixwell got into that the graveyard without even being spotted.
No, and I think just out of range as well for Sipnix to hear it. Very quick play here from Optic. 5-1 in the lead, Optic on the T side, and they're already charging out onto the B site, having taken down Dupree. Napfly gonna catch Sipnix looking the wrong way. And it's Kirby Glaive and Device, the last three alive here in this eco round for Astralis. So kind of going according to plan here for Optic. No real surprise that they're able to barrel through when there's only pistols waiting for him. Next round is when I want to see Astralis actually take a timeout, to be frank.
Yes, most definitely they need to do that. It's going to be five rounds in a row for the American team. And this happened after Astralis, you know, they got that one round after losing the pistol and it looked like it was going to be great, you know, that's everything you could hope for. And then Optic just bounced right back in their faces. Device, some internal timing that he's looking for here to get the kill maybe with the P250, but Rush will deny that one. So, 6-1, five rounds in a row for Optic here. And you're absolutely right, and there is the timeout for Astralis. Yep. They are going to call for it.
They have to tap out at some point. And this is, I mean, you have teams that will wait 6-0, 7-0, and call for the timeout. 6-1 going into a bye round as well for Astralis. This is the time to take a breather. Just sit and wait. And Glaive is doing a little bit of the talking right now. He is the in-game leader, the tactician of this team. But at this point is when Zonic, the coach, you can just barely see his head on the left over there, the spiky brown hair. He is the coach for Astralis. It's only during the timeouts that he can communicate directly to the team about tactics. I'm a bit surprised, actually, that Zonic isn't shouting as much as he was yesterday in the semis as well. Because he can't talk about tactics, he was just, you know, saying, good round, boys, keep it up. I mean, we're not really hearing that from Zonic at all right now. He's very quiet.
And that is what this timeout is all about. It's about the mental game. They need to find a way to believe that this can still work, because right now, they're just flushing it all down the toilet. It's 6-1, the eighth round is coming up here. They have the AWP, they have the M4s, and Optic, they have all the momentum, it seems. Device gonna miss the shot, he's trying to make it back around the corner. They can't quite catch him, so at least he gets away intact, but tries to set up a secondary angle here, and Optic, they're so aggressive. They're just trying to see if they can't roll them over here. Device looking for the shot, but he's not feeling confident enough to stick around. He wants to fall back and maybe get helped out by Kirby.
Exactly. When Kirby has to give ground and fall back, that's when Device realizes his flank is open, and so he just backs off a little bit. And now he's hunting, looking for the aggro shot, and he has stepped. They know that somebody's close.
Yeah, and even more than that, they can hear that scope going up and down. That's a bit of a problem. Right on the other side, Tarik and also Stan is waiting. And Device, he's slowly falling back, and now they're going to be wrapping around long. Backup needs to be called for here. This is a big crunch coming in. Optic, really early in the round as well. Kirby on top of the box looking for the spray, but he's not even close to connecting. And that is it. Stan and Mixwell, they open it up, and Dupree and Sid, they're already packing up their gear and walking away to save it here. What a push from Optic.
I'm surprised. These are unforced. That's like an unforced error for Kirby. Miss his spray that wildly. Definitely expect a bit more aim from him, and right now he's not delivering. Astralis, they're struggling. They take the timeout and they get run over completely. Zip and Dupree, they will survive. They're making this a bit more expensive for Optic, but they need the round, Astralis. They need to actually get a second round on the board here if they want to stand a chance. Optic are running away with this game right now in the first half. About to get seven rounds on T-side overpass. It's an excellent lead.
There's no denying it. And, I mean, I think it's true. It would have been great if Kirby could have got that spray. But the initial mistake actually happens when him and Device are so far up. This is the sandwich that's going on. Your Device is out in the open. There's no backup anywhere near. Both his teammates are way behind here. So he's just left to his own devices. It's not a good time at all.
No, it's those smokes going down just completely block him off from any kind of help. But, I mean, it's just to remind everybody, this is the first time you're watching Counter-Strike, we're looking for the first team to get to 16 rounds here. And this is the last map.
Yeah, you are tuning in to an otherworldly upset here. Optic Gaming, people have been doubting them all the way through. Right now, There's only one way to say it. They're winning the grand finals at the moment. Mixwell going to be getting a bit of a grenade. He actually bounces back in their face. Oh no, Dupree getting a little bit of help to set up a double kill.
We had to have an NA nade at some point in this final event. But yeah, you're right. That's just painful. That's almost some kind of round where you just shake it off if you're Optic, because it's definitely not how things are supposed to go down there in sewers, where you're going to get your own grenade bounced back at you. Still, it's not over yet. They did some damage to Dupree and Zipnix. Taric, Stanislaw, and Nafly still alive, and I do like this boost setup, hoping that somebody's still hanging around on short. It's not the case, though. Dupree has pushed Monster, and he might go all the way into T-spawn right now. Yes, he will. That's going to block off Connector. He can get into Connector and hamstring Optic.
Normally, I'd be a fan of this, but I'm not since they're in a 5v3. I feel like Astralis are taking a risk when, in fact, it's supposed to be Optic that are taking the risk because they're two men down. If this works out for Dupree, then I guess it's all good, but still, what if he turned around and got the kill? This can't be going down. What a shot from Nafly. Now Dupree, he's got the angle. They're lined up right in front of him, and he is going to be walking in. There's the spray. He drops the bomb with 24 seconds left, and it seems to be working out. Grenade out. He's going to be pushing even further. Takes down Taric. And a good double kill for Dupree. Pretty much closes out the round. Oh, what? Nafly! Hacking Dupree right through the wall. He's going to pick up the bomb and come charging down towards the B bomb site. Zip, he's up in the sniper nest. He can't quite land that shot, and not enough time for the plant here. What a great effort from Nafly, though. And also from Dupree, who does pick up a quad kill. Credit where it's due.
Yeah, exactly. It's the start of this round right here. He catches him lined up and wins this second duel versus Mixwell. That's the key turning point. Him going for the re-peak is him taking a big risk, but that's a confidence-building play that Dupree just managed to make work. The fact that it goes his way can potentially fire him up here for the rest of this half. And they need it right now, Astralis. They need a hero here that's going to come in and save them, because right now nothing is going their way. 2-7, Optic still in the lead, and of course with plenty of money to go for the full buy. Astralis as well after that round, but no AWP picked up here for Device. So that does leave you wondering a little bit. Instead, he's going aggro with the M4, and he's been spotted. Stanislaw with the lucky headshot through the smoke, though. That's going to put him down.
Yeah, but look at the spray that he got in, Device. I mean, he put Rush on 10 health in a single bullet. Any grenades that went over this wall would take care of Rush, but they don't know that, and they also don't have them. 2-7. This is the big test for Astralis. If they lose this round, I don't think they will have any steam left. That will reset the economy, and it's all going to go to hell.
Essentially. Well, if you're an EU fan, for an Optic fan, it's that big green wall bearing down on him. And well, speaking of which, it's the 4-5-man push out onto the B site. Nobody here for Astralis to greet them. Instead, they're both stuck in sewers. They've been smoked off from the site, perhaps. I do like it, though. Zipnix, this time, he goes for the spray. Denies Stanislaw on the plant.
That's a good angle to find. It makes the retake slightly easier, but it's still a 4-on-4 retake. Nafly hitting a good shot on Dupree now. The bomb still ticking right in front of him. Mixwell going to be pushing in, trying to take the fight with Glaive, and he's going to win it. He's not sure if there's a second player there, which we can tell there isn't. Kirby takes down Rush, 2 versus 3. They need this Kirby and Sipnix. It's up to them. And the timing here for Nafly, it's going to be everything. He's got the Tech 9. He goes down through the wall. Taric shooting Sip in the back, and Kirby, no health. He has to run. Optic picking up an 8th round.
Oh, do it! No! I thought he was going to get the wall bang. That would have been insult to injury. 5 HP left on Kevin. He barely makes it out. Mixwell just misses the timing to shoot him in the back as he's running. 14 kills for Mixwell, by the way, leading the charge. I know that guy right there.
You think Hector's
in the front,
excited?
I think he's pretty happy about how things are going right now.
I think Hector's excited. 2-8 is the scoreline. The 11th round is coming up, and Dupree is doing well. He's at 11 kills. But if you're even a little bit adept at reading facial expressions, you can tell that there is a bit of a breakdown. Everybody else on Astralis not really doing that much.
No. Low single digits. We're witnessing the collapse, and Optic know it. They're going for the throat straight towards B-side again. The smoke goes down, though, and that might throw Optic for a loop. They might have expected to get some kind of eco out of Astralis. Little do they know, Astralis have forced up, spent everything on this round. So that smoke causes a little bit of a pause here for Optic. They need to figure out exactly what they're going up against here.
Grenades coming up to the barrels, a very common position for somebody to be holding. Dupree standing near the pillar in the middle instead with just a pistol. Good flashbangs coming out here, and Taric gonna be going down. Actually, Dupree picks up a quick double kill. That's very well done. They will get a little bit of a return, and just because of the equipment difference here, it's working out pretty well for Optic. They are in a 2-on-2 though. Good kill from Kerbu, in fact. He's trying to get in there before the bomb goes down. A lot of counter smokes here. Device looking for the shot. Oh, he does the damage, but the bomb will still be planted ice cold from Mixwell. He doesn't stop even as he's being shot in the feet. Mixwell goes down, and that leaves Natfly. They see him, and Kerbu, triple kill.
The flash. You see a world in which Natfly is managing to trade the kill on short and turn it into a 1v1, but that flash costs him. And it's a three rounds on the board for Astralis, rather, as Optic have 8 rounds. Dupree, though, that perfect anti-flash, 2 anti-flashes, in fact, staggered, delayed. The first one halts Optic Gaming in their tracks, and when they just get going again, boom!
Round in this half from here on out, make it 7-8 if they want to stay competitive. And I mean, also just they want to build some confidence here. I just cannot even imagine what they must be feeling at the moment. That is a lot of damage being put in early on without Tarik on Natfly seeing anybody.
Oh, those wall bangs, painful to nade as well. Dupree hoping to get lucky to the smoke, but nobody is there. Well, Optic now, this is more of a default approach to the map where they're going to be waiting for contact. Spread out and waiting for Astralis to make the move to go aggressive. Mixwell will jump across though, so he's trying to set a little bit of a trap here in case Dupree goes aggressive again, because Dupree has pushed Monster here exactly where Mixwell's standing twice so far this half. But in the meantime, there's about to be some action in mid, and Device is still pushed up very aggressively. Stan is law with an excellent headshot. That's not supposed to happen. What a shot from Stan.
And now Dupree goes down. At least Sip can get the refrag. That's good news, but it's up to Kerbu and Glaive. They're right around the corner. Optic, if they steal this round away, they'll almost cement this first half. There's nothing that Astralis can really do to keep themselves alive. They're right around here. They've got such a big advantage against Kerbu. Sneaking in, but they don't know that he's quite there yet. A lot of smoke's raining into the B-bomb side, and that's going to confuse Sipniks. Will he call for backup? They get the kill on Kerbu. Now the only one who can stop this round from spiraling out of control is Glaive, and he's got only a UMP. Not exactly favorable. The bomb will go down before he gets there. Once he fires this gun, they're all going to know where he is, and it will be very difficult indeed. He's looking for the angle. There's the spray on Rush. That's a bit of a start. Now still a 2-on-3, and he gets caught with the grenade in hand. Sip picks up one. But at least the smoke is up on the bomb. Maybe that's going to help out Sip just a tiny bit. He's inside the smoke. He taps it once. Is he going to force them out? They're already trying to spray through. He gets the one shot. Sip, he sprays! And there's the quad kill. What an incredible clutch at the edge of losing this grand finals, essentially. Picks up that kind of a clutch.
We were talking about certain players having to wake up. It's been Dupree leading the way for Astralis for quite some time, but 4 kills. Zipnix pretty much doubles his kill count, going from 4 to 8. And this is what we were talking about when it came to Zipnix as well. We saw it a little bit on train, but on Cobble, he definitely wasn't present on the map. Zipnix with a huge win. Gotta be always so hype. There we go. That's right.
That's important. They need that hype. They need people to get excited. They need a couple of smiles every once in a while. I mean, it's very, very hard to play this game if nobody's communicating. And that's actually what it does to a lot of teams.
Oh.
When they start losing, they just don't talk anymore. And an interesting twist as Astralis win the round and then go for a tactical timeout.
Well, you can see the countdown has begun to get back into the round, and they're definitely in the zone. It's good to see the retake artist, Zipnix, back in his flow though in a key round. But Optic are not done yet. They had such a good bank to go off of that they can afford to go for full AKs and nades behind this. And they still have a very good lead right now. There's plenty of rounds left in this half. They can extend that. They can get into double digits. They just need to maintain their focus right now.
Let's see what tricks Optic have in the bag, because now at least a little bit's working. That's a nice shot for Device, taking down Stannis. Optic trying to see if they could chase him down, almost running into a second shot, but there's the backup. Kerbu, great defensive play, but Device will be going down. Glaive is there to follow up on Rush. It's looking good right now. They're in a 2-on-4. They need to stop fighting and just let this be, and instead they continue, and now they're in a 2-on-2 with the bomb about to go down. Astralis, where are the fundamentals?
Too much on the over-aggression, really trying to just batter Optic, but Optic They were too tough this round. They held in there, and now they've got a bomb plant and post plant positions as well. So now, so much time is going to burn off of this bomb. Where you see Dupree, he has to check all of these angles. He has no idea where the Optic players are holding from. Glaive is going to come through long, so they don't have to worry about that angle. Kind of narrows it down now to the mid area. And Naf going to go for the peak? What was that? Naf out in the open. It's on Taric now. 40 HP left for him. 1v2. Catches him lined up, but he doesn't get the spray. Dupree will clutch it, keep his cool, and clutch it in the end.
Oh, and it's the last second. It's incredibly close. But it does work out.
That's what? The shot the device attempted last time. That looked clean.
What you just saw in this round is a clear example. It's a clear read into the mindset of Astralis. When you put, when you're this far behind and your whole team is crumbling and you get yourself in a 2-on-4, you can't just keep fighting. And that doesn't make any sense. And it's a symptom of the fact that the team is just still breaking down, but they're at least putting rounds on the board. They've won 3 in a row. All of them have been defusers. So it's been real close. And Optic, they have money. They're just going to continue the pressure. And why wouldn't they?
Yeah, they aren't going to stop anytime soon. Perhaps in the next round, if they lose it, they might not be able to reset. But if they continue getting bomb plants, Optic, they can keep going for a long time as Astralis chain rounds together. But it is Optic. Playground occupied, and they are. They're not going to mess around this time. No Glaive and Kierby set up here in Connector. Mixwell taking the time to clear it out. And so a bit more map control here for Optic Gaming to decide to set up the play here, when they decide whether it's A or B. And right now that bomb making its way out long definitely makes you think A.
They've been so good at taking aim fights, and it's so much easier to do over at A long, so I don't blame them for it. Gonna make sure there's no one lurking around the restrooms, anything like that. They're taking all this map control early on in the half, which I really like. A lot of teams, they wait until there's just 40 seconds left, and then they start going for all this restrooms control, but Optic have it by 50 or even by a minute. They could do whatever they want at this point. They could fake A, run back to B, and actually that seems like what they might be doing.
Exactly, that bomb is making its way down into Connector, rotating over towards the B site. You have Taric and Rush making their way to Monster to back things up to get that two-pronged assault onto the site. But Zipnix and Dupree, we've seen how effective this hold, this crossfire can be between the two players. And if Dupree is hitting his shots, it could get brutal here for Optic. Zipnix going to spot the one, but Rush doubles up, takes down Dupree. Zipnix is so low on HP that he's not going to hold. And it's down to Glaive now. Up close with the UMP, bumping around in the smoke, and Device with the deny. No bomb plant happening.
Oh my god, just 14 seconds left. How is this working out? We spent half that round inside the smoke with Glaive trying to hock the terrorist player on the other side. Very, very weird.
That was... It's just like, where did Glaive come from? All of a sudden, the hero to the rescue. Zipnix and Dupree, they faltered.
I think a great attempt out of... I actually think that was a very good attempt out of Optic. On 100 different ways that could have worked out. Just a little bit confusing. 8-6 the scoreline. Moving into the 15th round, the last of the half. And regardless of what happens here, Optic are going to be excited about having even 8 rounds, I think, on the T side of this map. So, all on Astralis to make sure it changes. Zipnix, can you find a good grenade? There are 3 people in that tunnel. It could have been great.
Yeah, one thing to keep in mind is that Optic have a very solid CT side to fall back on here. Both sides looking very good for Optic on Overpass. It's a map that they're comfortable on. It's the map that they defeated FaZe on yesterday in the semifinals. And they got 10 rounds on their CT side. So, Astralis, even if they manage to get the 7 rounds, they've got a long road ahead of them. Optic have done a lot of work in this first half to set things up for them to win this grand finals. There's the flash, the setup. Dupree with the peak takes down Rush. Zipnix hanging around is going to allow himself to get traded. And there are 4 players here for Optic that are ready to go charging onto the site.
Taric in front of that charge. Tech 9 in hand, but he does go down to Dupree. And Glaive, bit of damage with the UMP, but not enough to get the kill. Still, he's stand alone, and he's going to get shut down. Good double kill for Kierby to close it out. 7-8. Slightly favoring Optic Gaming, still one hell of a performance from the American team. They should be very excited, they should be proud heading into the second half. That's what we're going to do right after the break. coming up between Astralis and Optic Gaming. And Optic, they don't run out of fuses. They just keep going all the way through. I'm very, very impressed by their playstyle and their stamina so far. We'll see if they can carry it all the way through. Mixwell has been playing out of his mind, and Dupree has done his absolute best to keep Astralis in this finals. The end score of the half is 7-8, and we'll see what happens after the pistol.
Between him and Zipnix, there's a lot of action. I mean, Kirby did good work coming back into it, but Dupree has been consistent throughout the entire first half for Astralis. It wasn't until the end, and I think it was mainly the massive clutch round coming in from Zipnix and Dupree after that that really launched Astralis back into this game and got them to get such a close score at the end of the first half. 8-7, this very well could have been 10-5, 11-4 Optic Gaming. So Astralis, they showed that they still had some fight.
Oh, Nat peeking in. Great headshot on device. Very well measured. A huge risk for him to take in case somebody else was down there, but it's definitely worth it now. Now Stan getting a couple of free pops off, but not really connecting enough with Kirby to get the kill.
Love
but
taps.
Still, yeah, why do they need it? They're in a 4v5, and now they can relax a bit more.
Can. They need to figure out exactly what's happening. He was looking for the follow-up, and it was a good ploy. Doesn't pan out. Still, Glaive has the flash and the smoke, though, and the P250, but he's got the utility. And with this bomb rotating back around over here, still a minute left on the clock. They could, with connector control, rotate back down to B if they wanted to complicate things here, Astralis. But taking over long like this does make you think that they want to wind up on that A site.
Yeah, I mean, here's the problem with taking over long in a pistol round. You're going to be facing that USP. You only have one smoke to block off Mixwell with. So if you miss the smoke by even an inch, you could be sure Mixwell is going to take at least one. And maybe the whole team, the way he's playing at this point, he's back at the bomb site, looking for it. No smoke has gone off yet. He's got clear rain of this. They do get very close at the moment. No bomb plant yet in 35 seconds. Mixwell going to get the headshot on Dupree. That's a 3-on-5. Where are the refracts coming in from Astralis? They need them, and they need them now. Kirby going to get one before he's out, but it leaves Zipnix alone in a 1-on-3. And they're just hunting him down slowly, click by click. They've got him isolated. And that fly, that's a quad kill for him in the round. Optic, they win another pistol here.
There we are. Definitely a strong start for his team right there. Second half, pistol one, and more importantly, Nafly continues to do work for Optic. He's now in the lead on the map as far as kills are concerned. But this is sick work from him, keeping his cool. Started off with the aggression, he just never let up. Astralis now, they're in deep water. 9-7, but you can see they have the pistols on Astralis. They can't afford, having lost that round, they can't afford to go to the rifles or the SMGs the way that Optic Gaming have.
Big challenge being mounted here for Astralis. I think they managed to recover a tiny bit of confidence at the end. You know, maybe they started to feel like we can actually do something. But if they lose the next couple of rounds, much of that is going to be gone. And Optic will be so close to the finish line that Astralis will have maybe just too big of a task on their hands.
Nice work. That's that one move from Zipnix baits out of smoke. Early utility in the fadeaway headshot on a rush. Okay, then. Now there's one less smoke to work with on that B site, and they're down a man as well. That's forced Nafly to rotate over towards the sniper, looking from on high. And Stanislaw desperate to bring the kill back. And he's going to spot Glaive, but he misses the shot. So a little bit of information gained there. And we might actually have the rotation coming in as well. Tarek isn't too far away up on that A site, but he doesn't want to fall back just yet. Because they don't have connector control. They don't know Optic Gaming if Astralis can rotate back around.
Oh, Naf actually taking quite a bit of damage early on here, so that's a bit of a problem. Stanislaw, he will be taking down Dupree. Now it's a 4-on-4. They don't have that much health on Optic, but they still have the equipment, so if they can keep that cool, keep it slow right now, and love this move from Stanislaw. Look at the aggression. He knows he has to take a risk. This could be the perfect play, and he takes down Kirby. Now 30 seconds left. If they push in, they have to look behind them all the time, and on the other side, Nafly there to pick up Glaive. 24 seconds. They'll get the bomb plant down, but Optic have set themselves up perfectly.
Yeah, now they know that they can go into this retake. It's all going to be down to the heroics. Device takes a peek. Get out! Optic are not playing around. 20 kills, 21 now for Naf. But more importantly, four players surviving and some excellent teamwork coming in there from Optic at the end. They're getting the kills, they're working the map, but more importantly, when they figure out, yes, the bomb is getting planted, they aren't rushing in and trying to give Astralis a way back into it. They wait for the rotation to come down from the A site and go in as four. Solid fundamentals here for Optic. This is really impressive to see from Optic as well. Coming into this tournament, I don't think anybody would have expected this kind of level. But right now, there's rolling over Astralis. 10-7.
doing a very, very good job. And especially after losing some of those early frags, that's when you tend to panic. You know, that's when some of the mistakes could come out. But they're handling all of these situations very well. A little bit of a flashbang on Glaive, and that's all they have for the round. So let's see if they can find a way to get maybe a kill or two. Another bomb plant would certainly help out. But it's hard to imagine this won't be an 11-7 scoreline favoring Optic. Especially when they have three men on this bomb site already. That's a brutal setup to run into when you don't have any armor at all. Rush playing it carefully. And Stanislaw picking up another two kills. Easy peasy.
Lemon squeezy. That was excellent control. Like, very... Like, Stanislaw, the fact that he gets them to line up at the end as well. That's just a feel-good moment. 11-7 now. And this is where we start getting into the serious round here for Astralis. The 19th round, and they can afford to go for the rifles, the grenades, and the AWP on device, who just barely has enough for the Kevlar, so... Clock ticks over, the round begins. We've got a minute 55 seconds now to see what Astralis have in store for us, or whether Optic Gaming are going to shatter their hopes, because again, three players pushing top mid right now, two into connector, and it's going to be Mixwell holding to watch their backs, but debris is down here. Clever play, actually. They wanted to go for the boost to look into the sewers pipe.
Speaking of device, he has gone missing in this game. Just like Sipnix did on the second map, this time Device has got 5 kills in 18 rounds. Just now starting in the 19th, that is obviously not good enough. So something needs to change. Otherwise, this won't be enough. They need to play more than 4-on-5. They've done it for one map and it didn't work out. If they're going to try it on this map too, it's just not worth it.
They need to rotate back up to the A side here, Optic. Minute left. Okay, they took the long route, the scenic route. Stanislaw and Tarek making their way back up there to back up Mixwell, but Mixwell is alone in restroom. He's only got the UMP holding a very aggressive angle up here. Glaive and Kierby, are they going to try and... Well, I mean, they're going to make their way around this corner soon enough. It's whether they flash their way through expecting some kind of trap waiting for them, or whether they walk right into this. Mixwell is perfectly capable of getting the headshot instantly.
And with the UMP as well, he's going to be fine if he can just trade that kill early on. Stanislaw is not that far behind, so... There could be a bit of a setup here. He's covering the other side, making sure that no one sneaks in behind Mixwell. We are down to 30 seconds. What a risk being pulled from Astralis, but they are making their way around long, which means Stanislaw and Mixwell are going to be slightly out of position. If they can get a kill, it's almost fine. And look at the timing! Stanislaw, he picks up both Dupree and Sipnix, and the rest of the push, it doesn't mean anything now. Kirby's going to get a headshot, but there comes Mixwell with the run and gun, UMP and Glaive. Not long for this world. It's all on Kirby with 8 seconds left. Nice mid-air headshot, but it's all just scenery at this point. He's going to be losing the round. Just can't do anything in that 1v3. Astralis, a lot of trouble. I mean, the timing for Stanislaw is just so good.
And what's tough is that it's Dupree, he's stepping, he makes noise, and that's what triggers Stanislaw to go and peek around the corner, because this is a common setup for the T side to get those smokes down. You're vulnerable when you have your smoke in your hand. Obviously, you don't have your gun. Stanislaw, it's a calculated risk, and it pays off massively for his team there. 12-7, and well, it's starting to look pretty grim here for Astralis. The hero AK bought by Kirby, and the rest of them...
Well, that's from the last round.
Pardon me?
I think that she saved it.
Oh, he saved it from the last round, you're right. Still, pistols and Kevlar here for the rest of Astralis. But you're right, that is the saved AK.
Well, yes, if it turns into a hero AK, that would certainly, you know, just make things a tiny bit brighter. But honestly, they seem like they have almost no fight in them left anymore. They're getting timed all of the time. Dupree lands a headshot on Rush. That's not at all bad. I'm not sure if Sip saw that there was someone down there. Maybe spotting out the feed, but getting a little bit hot up there.
That's a nasty play, making him dance. We have the swap around from the gear. Device was the insurance, actually, with the Kevlar helmet. Now he can go for the AK. And if ever there was a time for him to come alive, it is now. Stanislaw, not sure if he's hearing the jump on the other side of the wall there, but that's a little bit of information to go off of. Four players rotating around for Astralis. Nafly will catch Glaive in mid. That's the trap that has been broken open there by Optic. Astralis, they were counting on Glaive to catch out the rotators. Instead, now the B defense is going to be pretty solid here. Stanislaw, excellent shot.
Yeah, great flick. That bomb, if the grenade goes in, it's going to deny the bomb pump. Oh, just make it as he explodes that HE. All on device, 1v4. He's going to get one good headshot in, but they should be able to swarm him. There's just too much here. He's going to get one more in. Taps away. Device looking the wrong way. Tearing us out. Oh, my lord. Device taking 4 kills. And Astralis somehow coming out. A godlike performance from Device in that round. He disappears for a very long time. But when he shows up, he does this.
Oh, it's so tough. In a key round, everything falls apart for Optic. They run in one after another against Device. 1v4 clutch, and it is the AK from Kevy that makes a difference. Just hold on to the AK at this point, Device.
They're talking now. They're finally a little bit animated on the Astralis side. We are seeing a tactical timeout for Astralis. The money is still there for Optic Gaming, but if they lose this round, they're going to be broken, and that will allow Astralis to creep ever closer to equalizing the scoreline here.
All right, Tarek doing a bit of talking right now. The countdown is practically over here going into it. 12-8, Optic. Still fine as far as the buy is concerned, but their economy is gone. And in the meantime, Astralis, of course, full bot after that massive win there from Device. So Astralis, early pressure over here by Monster. They're getting into the fight fairly early on. Device has already got the angle, and they're going for the identical setup here, Optic. And this time it works. Stanislaw's going to catch Dupree out in Sewers. And Optic start off strong. Not a single point of damage taken. And Kiarvi's already down to 42.
Great setup. Very creative. And also fairly low risk. It's hard for them to be pushed actually in connector. And someone coming through the tunnel is not going to have an easy time spotting that out, because you're always going to be busy worrying about the potential jump or even someone pushing up in front of you. A good smoke up towards the sniper nest, and now looks like Astralis are going to come into this push. They need the early frag, but Kirby goes down. Sip gets one, but then he's traded, and Glaive to follow Device in another one-on-four, and this time it won't work out so well. He goes down. That resets the economy. They win a single round, the first round that they win on their T side, and immediately afterward, Optic are right back.
Right back in it, and within striking distance now as well. This is that moment when a team gets up to 13 rounds where there's an additional amount of pressure that gets put on Astralis, weight on their shoulders, because now, if you lose a round, they're almost on match point here. And that's it, match point. This is the last map of the Grand Finals, and Optic need three rounds for the North American upset.
It is happening right here, right now. You're watching it unfold live. Nafly at 24 kills. He is doing such a remarkable job right now. Mixwell at 20. Tarek and Rush are a little bit behind, but it doesn't matter. The team as a whole is functioning incredibly well. This is the beauty of Counter-Strike as an esport. It's just so unpredictable at times. But when you got five people working together with the same goal, pulling in the same direction, this is what can happen. Rush, Stan, and Nafly down on the B bomb site. Sure, Astralis have the tech nines, but how are they going to get through all these smokes?
Sure, Nafly is going to be there to back them up, because he is thinking about rotating up. He can actually get above, unless they get that smoke down on Sniper, in which case he's going to be cut off. They do have the grenades necessary for this execute. Astralis, Dupree waiting in Swords, Zipmix, Kirby, and Device ready to go through Monster. But the crossfire is established between Stanislaw and Rush. And that one incendiary, it's going to buy them so much time. There's the flash, and that smoke as well. This is just staggering Astralis. They have a couple of flashes left, and they're just going to commit straight through. Stanislaw with the spray, not connecting, just doing a bit of damage here and there. But then the kills come through, and Stanislaw with two. Rush with the one, backing him up. And they just ran right into the blender, Astralis. They had no chance. Optic, that defense on B, it's too tough.
And it's, I mean, the timing is incredible as well for Optic. That Molotov goes down right after Astralis have put all their grenades in. That means they can't just wait. You know, if the Astralis had thrown no grenades, they would have just waited for the Molotov. There was 15 seconds left, or 50 seconds, so it would have been no problem. But because the timing is godlike, that means they have to eventually commit to it. And when the smoke goes down after the Molotov, they know we've got no chance. We've got to go through eventually. 14-8. Ooh. Two more rounds, and Optic take the Grand Finals.
Stanislaw, I mean, perhaps trying to make the life just a little bit easier for Astralis. Goes ahead and roasts himself there real quick in the fire. He's down to 65 HP at the beginning of this round. But Astralis have changed up their approach, no longer going towards the B site. They've got the bomb over on long, that's Kirby. And in the meantime, Device is clearing out restrooms. So it's back to the A site now. It has been fairly even between both sides for Astralis. But they're gonna see if they can make it happen here. And Mixwell takes the shot, and I think he hit the lamppost. Yeah.
How can that be real? We need a replay of that production.
Oh, wow.
Please.
Let's go, boys. More grenades getting wasted. Oh, Mixwell. Another. Take a breath, man.
Everyone calm down. This is in the bag. Now is not the time to be frustrated. 23rd round coming up here. They got a strong defense at the A bomb site, but Astralis, they're going to try and test it. They run close with the Tech-9s. Mixwell can't really see anything. Napfly, easy shot for him, and that drops the bomb. Kebu should have been putting it down. Napf with a triple, and now Sip and Devicer left 2-on-3. 24 seconds, a great kill for Mixwell, and Sipnik's now alone and isolated and out of time. They needed that bomb plant right off the bat, and they never got it. And Sip, he knows as soon as... Oh, what? He takes down Rush. That's a great start. 9 seconds. He's going to follow it up, but he can't. Gets taken out by Stanislaw. Match, map, tournament point for Optic Gaming.
That's right. What a play from Math. Those two kills. Unbelievable. Zipnik did the best that he could, but there's only so many 1v3s, 1vxs that you can win in a day.
What is it going to take for Napfly to smile? He's at 28 kills in 23 rounds in the biggest game of his life, and they need the one more round, and they're going to be the champions. Astralis deflated and almost defeated here. They've got a Galil, they've got some pistols, they got a lot of grenades. How do they break through the green wall? It does not seem like they can.
There will be one of those memes. The meme, you know, where it's just like, happy Napfly, sad Napfly, frustrated Napfly, it's all the same face. And then it's gonna be the final tournament, tournament winning Napfly. And I think that'll crack a grin.
He's the North American exist, is what you're saying.
Exactly. I mean, Mix has got the angle! He hits the shot as well. Glaive down to 21. Must have caught just a little bit of the concrete there. But Glaive, he can count his lucky stars.
Just a warning shot, just to make sure that Glaive realizes he's no longer welcome. 55 seconds here. Clock is running down. This could very well be the final round. Stanislaw and Rush are on the other side, and they have been rock solid on this B bomb site so far. Have they got any grenades left? Not entirely, but the flash spray is coming through. They do get traded fairly quickly. Rush, he's going to be run down. Device with the Tech-9. Finally picking up a bit of speed and a good little smoke coming out on top to make sure that no one can get a clean shot in. 3 versus 4, and the bomb is down. Optic, can they get another retake in? Tarik going down, almost making sure that it can't happen.
Exactly. Now it's too tough a situation. Mixwell has to take advantage of that smoke clearing to make the cross and be able to back off to save this gun. And all the money, they might, if they can hold on to both of these guns, they should be able to get a buy. They will be able to get a buy, Optic. It's not done here. They don't have to go to pistols and try and save up. But that's a tough scenario there. I wonder what the follow-up flash looked like to just catch Rush flush like that, because he was follow-up blind. You're thinking, okay, Stanislaw gets run over. Sure, fair enough. But then how is Rush not able to see to get the follow-up there and actually make it first? Because if it's a 3-on-3 retake scenario, you can be sure Optic are attempting it. They're going to go for that fight.
Yeah, you see, it's definitely a very good flashbang that lands on Rush there. He's just full blind the whole duration.
That's the man right there trying to make a difference for his team. The two key kills there in the replay, Device will bring them to the fore, but 12 kills total on this map for Device. Dupree still leads the way with 20 kills, but now he's the only one up at 20. You have three players above 20 kills for Optic. Optic are just hitting harder.
Much, much harder at this point in time. Seem like they're different weight classes at this point. 9:15. Mixwell over. Long tries for the gap shot there, but doesn't quite get it on Device. That would have been a great way to get started. Device just a little bit worried.
Yeah.
Not sure if he's going to be re-peeking.
Not always a good time to go facing an op. One shot. Oh, Mixwell not going to get the timing either. He cannot see the outlines through the smoke or through the walls the way that we can. And so it would just be instinct if he were to hit mouse one there. No targets just yet. And instead, again, Astralis, they're going to go for the rinse and repeat here. Onto the B side, it looks like. Bombs outside of Monster, and three players set up and ready for Optic Gaming. The defense this time around, it'll be established, and they've changed up the setup as well. Stanislaw is looking into the wall so he can avoid the flash all the way back here in the corner.
I love this setup, and I love the fact that they still have a Molotov down there on Napfly. That's going to make life even more difficult, especially if the clock runs too low. 45 seconds, putting a couple of shots with the smoke on the terrorist side here. Are they going to be able to withstand this time? Stan goes down immediately, and Rushy only gets the one kill. Nat turns up, he gets one, he gets two, but finally gets taken out. Hero effort from Natfly puts him at 30 kills and puts his team in a 2-on-2. The bomb plant is happening, and Dupree in a sublime situation here, trying to see if he can maybe get the flank in as they try and push through. Molotov on Mixwell trying to hide in the corner. Is it going to spread far enough? It looks like he's going to be safe for the moment. Just a little bit lucky there. Taric looking to move up, not going to get Sipnixon. Instead, it's a triple kill for Sip, in fact, and Mixwell trying for the wallbang once and has to maybe make it out with the AWP. This is a hard one to try and clutch, and he goes down. Quad kill for Sipnix. 10-15.
Not giving up on this fight, Astralis. And this to me speaks of a setup that Stanislaw wasn't used to. And perhaps it comes down to Rush with the call. Rush hesitating caused Stanislaw not to turn around and not to have any impact. If Stanislaw or Rush, or either one of them, if they pick up a kill when that push begins, totally different situation. And I think Optic are now hoisting that trophy into the air. But just a little bit of shakiness there on the communication ends up costing Optic a chance. And now they are on pistols here. It is Astralis with control of the situation.
For once, that puts Optic back on pistols. They've had such an incredible economy throughout this second half. They've managed to save just enough rifles when it really matters. And they've just been keeping it alive for a very long time. But now, it is back to pistols and no armor. So Astralis is trying to get a free round in here. But the pressure is still unbelievably, and all of the pressure is on Astralis still. Optic, no. And they have good reason to believe that as soon as they get rifles in their hands again, they can close out this game.
They should not be feeling overly flustered. They still have a margin for error. They are setting a little bit of a trap over here in connector. Stanislaw, whoop, never mind. Glaive with the drive-by. Dupree will run into Stanislaw, but Stanislaw wins that fight. 12 HP, and thanks to the Kevlar. But not going to be able to live longer than that. Glaive will take him out. So Taric, Rush, and Nafly still alive here for Optic Gaming.
A Sip is watching down in the tunnels in case anyone tries to make it through that side. Did he spot the feet? I think maybe he did. Yeah, look at that. They're well aware. The boost is up, though. Glaive is going to get caught. Good spray from Sip. That's very, very important. And Taric will also be going down. So Rush, P250 on the bomb site with 29 seconds. They're all coming for him. You want to fight him straight up. Got to be very careful. That could have got out of control. If he hit the headshot on Sip, it would have been a 1v1. 15-11, though. And now Optic have money to buy one more time.
This is Naf. That's just a tough situation there for Glaive. But this is it, the moment. 15-11. And the rifles are here, the nades as well. And now it's a question, I think, of whether Mixwell goes aggro with the AWP or not. Is he going to try and take control of the situation here? Are Astralis even going to give him the chance? Yes, Astralis will be rotating into mid. For a second there, it looked like perhaps they wanted to head towards Monster early on, but instead it's Sipnix alone. Taric is here, and it's a big setup coming in. Long push, they haven't done this yet. Mixwell finds a shot on device, and this could be the turning moment. Jeremy, though, going to catch him turned around, but he misses his chance.
He needed to get that kill. They still got a chance to bring it back. A flashbang goes out, so at least it's a 4-on-4, but Kirby could have maybe even got the double kill. Now Nat flies down here, the hero of Optic Gaming. He goes for the spray, catches Dupree perfectly, follows up with a headshot on Sipnix. This guy in the grand finals, 34 kills now. He just needs another couple and they will have that trophy. It's going to be Kirby and Glaive left with over a minute, but in a 2-on-4, spray comes through. Rush gets a kill, and ladies and gentlemen, Optic Gaming, your winners of E-League Season 2. What a story, what a surprise. Who would have seen that coming? I don't think there was even a single analyst, a single expert anywhere that